Megana T. Bhujang.
We are in 4th semester, Computer Science Department, SCVIT.
This video is about the first experiment in microprocessor lab, bubble sort and its execution.
This video is done under the guidance of Dr.Mallikarjunaswamy, Associate Professor, CSE Department, SCVIT.
With the help of our cinematographer, Preethi.
The very first program in the 4th semester microprocessor lab is the bubble sort. Before going into the learning part and the execution of bubble sort, let us know what it is. Bubble sort basically is the simplest algorithm which is undertaken to arrange the numbers in ascending or descending order. Now let us take an example of 5 integers and see how bubble sort works. In the first pass, it compares 70 with 60, and 60 is a lesser number compared to 70. So these two numbers swap their places and the other numbers remain in their original position. Next, it compares 70 with 2, and since 2 is a lesser number compared to 70, these two numbers swap their places and these two numbers remain in their original position. The same process takes place twice, and at the end of the first pass, we see that the 70, which is the largest number among these integers, is put in the last position.
Now that we know how bubble sort works, we need to implement it in assembly language. Before implementing, we should have a basic knowledge about it. In assembly language, there is general purpose register, AX, BX, CX and DX. AX is arithmetic register, BX is address register, CX is count register, DX is extra. Each of this register is 16 bits. If we consider 8086 microprocessor of memory location 1 megabyte, it is divided as follows. It has 4 data segments, 4 stack segments, 4 code segments, 4 extra segments and 1 interrupt. Each segment is 64 kilobits. Since there are 4 data segments, it is 64 kilobits into 4. Now, to access this, we have pointer registers and index registers. The pointer registers are IP instruction pointer. It points to the next instruction in code segment. This is base pointer, starting pointer. It contains offset in stack segment. These two are index registers, source index, destination index. This is used to access data segment. This is used to access extra segment.
This is the program to execute bubble sort in assembly language. The first line is dot model summary. It has two segments, one data segment and one code segment. Data segment stores data and the code segment has the executable part. This line is a list of elements where DW refers to data word and each element is of 16 bits. And this is how the data is stored. There are 5 numbers under consideration here, so initially the count is equal to 5. Now coming to the code part, start, move AX, add data. Here add data refers to the starting address of the DS unit. Now this value will be stored in AX, so AX is equal to 0. Move DS, AX. The value of AX will be stored in DS, and this is an example for register-register transfer. Move DX, count minus 1. This step is used because we are keeping one variable constant, and there are 4 comparisons. And count minus 1 will be equal to 4, and that will be stored in DX. Again 0. Move CX, DX. The value of DX will be stored in CX. So now CX will also be equal to 4. Move SI, offset list. Offset list also refers to the starting address of the data segment, and that will be stored in source index SI. Initially, the value of SI is 0, 0. The first line in again 1 is move AX, SI. This is indirect addressing mode. So the value in 0, 0 will be stored in AX. In 00 to 0070, and that will be stored in AX. Then we compare AX and SI plus 2. SI plus 2, that is the value stored in 02, it is 0060. Comparison always happens with respect to destination. This is source and this will be destination. So with respect to AX, 0070 is greater than 0060. So this line is ignored and the values are exchanged. On swapping, the value is stored here.
the value of SI will be 0 to 2. And loop again 1. So the count will be decreased. In again 1, again SI, that is 0 to move to AX. In 0 to we have 0070, so AX will be 0070. And we compare AX with SI plus 2. SI plus 2, that is 0 to plus 2 is 4, we have 0002. Then we compare with respect to AX, 0070 is greater than 0002, so again starting point. When we start, the value is 15. After swapping, again SI is incremented by 2. SI will be. Then again we loop, so count is incremented by 1. And then we move AX to 10. So in 04, it is 0070. That is AX will be the same. And we have to compare it with SI plus 2. So SI plus 2, 0010. Again, we compare with respect to AX. 0070 is greater than 0010. So we swap the values. After swapping, these two as well. After swapping, SI is incremented by 2. So SI will be 06. Then we loop to again 1. Count is 0. But move AX from SI, it will be 06, so it's 0070. AX will be 0070. Then we have to compare it with SI plus 2. SI plus 2 is 0055. We compare with respect to AX, 0070 and 0055. This is greater than this, so this line is again ignored and we exchange the values. On swapping,
edit is used to open the file in MASM directory. Now, you're supposed to type the program and save it with the extension .azip. As you have already typed and saved the program, we'll be opening it. The program name should be less than 5 characters. And this is our program. Once you have saved it, you need to go to file and then exit. To run the program, we give the following commands. ZI command is used for the compilation of the program out of type. This command is followed by semicolon. And once you press enter, it shows there are no errors. And once there are no errors, you give the following command. This command is used to link the program. It says there are no stack segments used. And it is followed by cvbarp command. The run window is opened. Now you go to run, click on start. And then give the following command. And once you press enter, all the numbers which you have given as input will be arranged in ascending order. As you can see, the first 5 places are filled with garbage values. To get rid of them, you give the following command and then press enter. the garbage values are gotten away. There is another way of executing the program. By pressing F8 continuously, you can see the values changing on the right hand side of the window.